करते हैं तो कोरोनरी कार्सिनोमा क्या है तुम लोग जानते हो, क्लिनिकल फीचर क्या है तुम लोग जानते हो। तो सर यूटीसी तो मुझे सर, थैंक यू। तो अपन कोरोनरी कार्सिनोमा के बारे में अगर क्लिनिकल फीचर, ओनली क्लिनिकल फीचर अगर डील करते हैं तो जैसे कि हम लोग सुने होंगे जैसे कि अपना बच्चे लोग, छोटे छोटे बच्चे जिद करते हैं दादा नाना लोगों को कि कहानी सुनाओ बोल के, उनका मूड नहीं होता है सुनाने के लिए। तो क्या करते हैं, एक था राजा एक था रानी, दोनों मर गए, खत्म कहानी, है ना। सो टुडेज टॉपिक दैट इज बीन अलर्टेड इज कार्सिनोमा कोलन क्लिनिकल फीचर। सो ओनली क्लिनिकल फीचर्स अगर अपन पढ़ते हैं तो इट विल बी टू स्मॉल ए टॉपिक, टू स्मॉल ए टॉपिक, बिकॉज मेनली जनरल ओनली थ्री मेन क्लिनिकल फीचर, तीन को बढ़ा चढ़ा के जितना बना के लिख सकते हो। सो कितना पढ़ोगे, दैट्स व्हाई व्हाट यू शैल डू इट दैट। उसी कोरोनरी कार्सिनोमा का बारे में थोड़ा सा आगे और थोड़ा सा पीछे, वी शैल ऐड टू इट सो दैट यू कैन ऐड टू आवर जनरल नॉलेज समथिंग। नाउ क्वेश्चन कम्स, कोलन, व्हाट इज द कोलन, व्हिच पार्ट ऑफ द इंटेस्टाइन इज नोन एज कोलन। कोलन जर्मनी में एक जगह है, COLONE बोलते हैं, तो प्रोनाउंसिएशन कोलन हो जाता है, जिसमें कुछ खुशबू उसबू वाला सामान वाना मिलता है कोलन वोलन करके। बट हियर वी आर डीलिंग अबाउट द बॉडी, इनसाइड द बॉडी व्हिच पार्ट इज नोन एज कोलन। एनीबॉडी वॉलंटियर प्लीज, व्हिच पार्ट ऑफ द इंटेस्टाइन इज नोन एज कोलन। नोबडी, मैं देख नहीं रहे हैं तुम लोग, तुम लोग मुझे देख रहे हो, मैं देख नहीं रहा हूं। सो यू कैन टेल, यू विल टेल एनीथिंग इफ इट इज रॉन्ग, नो प्रॉब्लम।
तो इट्स पार्ट ऑफ लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन प्रेजेंट इन द राइट इलियाक रीजन।
अच्छा, और एनीबडी हु वुड लाइक टू इम्प्रूव अपन दिस इज टेलिंग पार्ट ऑफ लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन व्हिच इज लोकेटेड इन द राइट इलियाक फोसा। एनीबडी वांट्स टू इम्प्रूव अ लिटिल बिट व्हिच पार्ट ऑफ द लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन और एनीथिंग एल्स इन द इंटेस्टाइन व्हिच इज नोन एज कोलन। एक्चुअली यू नो योर GI ट्रैक्ट, गेस्ट्रो इंटेस्टिनल ट्रैक्ट इज डिवाइडेड इनटू सम एंटीरियर पार्ट एंड सम पोस्टीरियर पार्ट, दैट इज प्रॉक्सिमल पार्ट, दैट इज फ्रॉम द माउथ टू द ड्यूओडेनम। बियॉन्ड दैट इट इज द स्मॉल एंड लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन, एंड द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन बिगिंस वेयर द स्टोमक एंड्स, दैट इज पार्ट ऑफ ड्यूओडेनम, एंड एंड्स वेयर दिस लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन बिगिंस। बट वेयर डज दिस लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन बिगिंस, इट बिगिंस फ्रॉम द आइओसीकल जंक्शन, जहां आइलियम एंड होता है, फ्रॉम द आइओसीकल जंक्शन एंड एंड्स एट द रेक्टम। बिगिंस एंड एंड्स, दैट इज टोटल इज 1.5 मीटर इन लेंथ, क्वाइट ए लॉन्ग पार्ट। सो इट इज नॉट ओनली इन द राइट इलियर फोसा, इट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम द राइट इलियर फोसा, ascends of the ascending part, then starts the first part is the cecum, cecum, then it will ascend the ascending colon, then the hepatic flexor, transverse colon, splenic flexor, descending colon, that and sigmoid colon. This is where the sigmoid colon ends, that is at the rectum. So this whole part is known as the large intestine or the colon. And if you add the rectum to this, this consists of the colorectal part. Of the colorectal part, that is almost all part of the lower GIT, excepting the anus. So your ileocecal junction up to the anus, this part is known as this large intestine, and this part is mainly colon. So any carcinoma here may be in the cecum, may be in the ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon, or the sigmoid colon. You can call it a carcinoma of the colon. Carcinoma, as you all know, is a malignant disease. And this, when you open the abdomen, how do you differentiate the small intestine and large intestine? How do you differentiate the colonic part and small intestine part? Number one, from the caliber. The small intestine part is more longer part, the thinner part. And the large intestine part is relatively shorter than the small intestine, but it is wider. And from the outside, you will see in the large intestine, there will be, what are there? Three muscular lines, three longitudinal muscles in the large intestine give the identification to the large intestine or colon when you open the abdomen. Either you remember from your anatomy class or from your surgery book, any discussion, any time, three long musculatures are there over the wall of the large intestine. Three. Those three terminates or converge at the iosecal junction from where the appendix starts. So what are those things? Anybody, what is the name of the muscles? No? Tinea coli. There are three tinea, and because it is over the colon, it is coli. It is known as coli. Tinea coli, three tinea coli are there. If you see the tinea coli, are longitudinal muscles running parallel to each other, excepting at the terminal part, you will think the structure is large intestine and it's not small intestine. Then, what other thing you will find the appendices apopleiki. Appendices apopleiki are some, I can say, folds of peritoneum containing fat. Folds of peritoneum containing fat. So appendices apopleiki, when it is there, over the structure, it is the large intestine. So that is the, how you differentiate from small intestine to large intestine. And you know the extent of large intestine. Now tell me, what is the function of large intestine? Or colon, that matter. What is the function? Anybody? Ek to batao.
Assimilation of food.
Pardon, yeah?
Sir, assimilation of food.
Not assimilation will not be a proper word. Number one, transportation. Food, yes. Jo transport kar rahe, food matter ko. Either semi-digested or digested food matter. Because by the time it reaches the large intestine, main digestion part is over. Main digestion part is over, and because it contains the fecal matter. So main part is over, digestion has been done. Small intestine has absorbed all it. Whatever assimilated to it has done already done. So what is there? Now what it will do? It will preserve. So jo bhi preserve kar sakta hai, it will preserve. And kya preserve karega? It preserves mainly the water. It preserves the water and helps in absorption of some of the things like glucose, some chloride. These things are absorbed directly from the large intestine also. If perchance or due to some disease, the absorption is not effective or absorption work of the large intestine has been hampered, then what will happen? What will happen to the feces? Anybody from Chhattisgarh, from you, do you understand what is a kokni guy? Sometime back there is a joke in some paper, Hindi paper, because this Chhattisgarh state government is purchasing cow dung. Now the question was there, question was put, ask Mupesh Dawa whether he will purchase the cow dung of kokni guy in liter or in kg. Because that cow dung is liquids only, and there is plenty. So your feces will be plenty and only in the liquid form. It will not solid form, semi-solid form may nahin hoga. If large intestine will stop its function of absorption. So absorption is water absorption. So kya hoga, either diarrhea hoga, डिहाइड्रेशन होगा. सो एब्जॉर्प्शन इज इम्पोर्टेंट है. एब्जॉर्प्शन में क्या क्या, पानी तो करेगा ही, साथ में सम ऑफ दी ग्लूकोज, सम क्लोराइड एंड सम रेयर आइटम्स विल बी देयर दैट इज इट एब्जॉर्ब्ड. दैट इज द मेन फंक्शन. नाउ सेकंड पार्ट, व्हाट अबाउट द कंटेंट. यू सी व्हाट आई एम टेलिंग यू, दो दिस इज I told you that this will be addition to your general knowledge, but addition to your general knowledge of functioning of DGIT, because sometime of when we shall be discussing it, that may also come. Some part may be we shall be discussing it. So now what we are telling, that large part of large function of large intestine is absorption, is it? So now the large intestine is having mainly two part, one proximal part, the other is distal part. What is the proximal part? It is the cecum, the ascending colon, and part of the transverse colon. Then the rest part is the distal part. What happens is that the proximal part, that is the right side of this colon, the matter inside, fecal matter that is there inside the large intestine is liquid form. Gradually, when it absorbs the water, that becomes semi-solid. So by the time it reaches the rectum, it is semi-solid. Rectum में भी कोई absorption को बात कर करीब करीब ना के बराबर है. दो डी little bit of water absorption is there. Rest function is not the only transportation purpose which will be used. So proximal part more liquid, distal part more like solid. So that is the difference of the fecal matter in large intestine in this part and the other part. So that is in anatomy. That is कहाँ से start होता है तुम जानते हो, कहाँ end होता है जानते हो. Anatomy total discuss करने के लिए अभी time नहीं है. Remember, this part is supplied by the artery of the mesentery. That is superior mesenteric and inferior mesenteric. Up to the splenic flexure, superior part branches of the superior mesenteric. Besides that, the branches of the inferior mesentery. So splenic flexure, both it gets a little bit of supply from this side, that is the superior mesenteric side, and some part from the inferior mesenteric side. That is important because while doing some surgery in the splenic flexure, that part may bleed a little bit more. So one has to be careful. And because the other rest part is having single artery supply, if you tie it, that part becomes anemic. And that may lead to colitis or other complications will be there. Ischemic colitis. So, and what about the venous supply? Sir, venous return. Venous return generally follows the that of the artery, excepting that some part of the venous return goes to the portal vein. Some parts go to the portal vein and lymphatics. Are close the arteries common. So that is the arterial supply, venous drainage, and lymphatic drainage. Why lymphatic drainage and venous drainage are important? Because we are dealing case of carcinoma where metastasis may be a finding. Now, yeah, these things are in general. Now question comes about the carcinoma of the colon. Fortunately or unfortunately. Carcinoma of the colon is not very, very, very common in India. We thank God that it is not very common in India. Why it is not common? I shall discuss a little bit. And so, which part of the country? If the question comes or somebody asks you, which part of the world carcinoma colon is more common, and which part is least common? So, most common are the developed country. The European countries, America, those are the countries where the incidences are quite high. Rather, in England, carcinoma colon is the second highest. And in USA and England, it is mainly in England, it is the second highest cause of carcinoma and one of the great killer. Whereas in India, it will be sixth or seventh cause. Can anybody guess what will be the top most killers or top most case of carcinoma in India?
Oral cancer.
Correct. And what else? One is oral cancer. What else? Oral cancer, which part of the country? Oral cancer, which part of the country?
Carcinoma lungs.
Carcinoma lungs, okay, correct. What else?
ये कितने पड़ते हैं?
What else?
Breast cancer.
Yes, three. What else? Anything else? Why you are orienting the cervix? Cervical cancer, one of the commonest cancer in India. So cervix, breast, two more common. And most those two are the per female. Oral cancer more common in males. Oral cancer more common in areas of tobacco chewing, gutka chewing, and reverse cigarette smoking. They smoke reversely, that is the burning part in the mouth. Which state in India? Smoking in the burning part of the mid ear, burning part of the throat. The Andhra, part of Maharashtra, part of Telangana. These area, they smoke, they do a reverse smoking. That reverse smoking, that heat, along with tobacco, that causes the ulcer. And eastern part of India, Odisha, Bengal, Bihar, Panchi, Bihar and UP, tobacco khaini, gutka, now it is all India phenomenon. Thanks to the Manikchand gutka, Kothari and Madimchand, whatever they have given, we don't know, but they have given the increased incidence of oral cancer. So that is the story in India. And cervical cancer, breast cancer, somebody told lung cancer is correct. And next will come carcinoma of the stomach. Iske baad hi number aa sakte hai GIT ka, lower GIT ka, it is colon and rectum and anus, etc. So that is a fortunate thing. Now question comes, why these so-called civilized people, they may not be civilized that to that extent, but they show themselves to be more civilized. They eat this toad food, rather it is tinned red meat, processed and tinned red meat. And what we Indian eat? We eat lot of fiber in the food, vegetables, gehum, khane se bhi apan, we do not prefer maida, we prefer atta, chawal, whatever these things, they have a lot of fiber content. So increased fiber content propagates the food easily and early in the large intestine. There is no storage, less constipation. European people, little food, mostly protein in form of meat, they have to constipating in habit, slow motion, all the poisonous material of this red meat and others stored in the large intestine for longer period, working as a carcinogen, causing carcinoma. So our food habit, the type of food. Now the second question, the second part of the, not question, this is the second part. Our food is little spicy. Punjab jaoge, tadka milega, whatever milega is spicy. सदन जाओगे तो मिर्ची मिलेगा, ईस्टर्न जाओगे भी मसाला मिलेगा, अगर वेस्टर्न पार्ट जाओगे तो गो टू वेस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया कोंकणी फूड, तो महाराष्ट्र डिशेस, इफ यू गो टू महाराष्ट्र यू क्रॉस नागपुर क्वेश्चन इज दैट थोड़ा तेज कर दें, इफ यू आस्क इन रेस्टोरेंट सम फूड दे विल आस्क थोड़ा तेज कर दें मतलब मिर्ची डालना, आप नहीं समझते हो दैट मीन्स अच्छी से मिर्ची मिलेगा, मैं सफर कर चुका हूं उससे एक बार, तो तेज करना, तेज फूड दैट स्पाइसी फूड दैट हेल्प्स दैट प्रिवेंट्स कार्सिनोमा, सो इट्स नॉट ओनली एवरीथिंग इज बैड दैट मे बी कॉजिंग एडिबल हाइपर एसिडिटी और व्हाटएवर गैस्ट्रिक बर्निंग एटसेट्रा, बट इट इज गुड हियर दैट इज गिविंग अस इम्यूनिटी और दैट इज प्रिवेंटिंग कार्सिनोमा ऑफ द कोलन, दैट इज फूड एंड देयर इंग्लिश पीपल व्हाट दे आइदर दे विल बी ड्रिंकिंग दिस कोल्ड ड्रिंक और बियर और दारू that is wine, and whatever food, that is mainly canned food, stored and canned food. So for you all people, कभी का आप तो एंजॉय करना ठीक है, but should not make it a point. जिन लोग रेगुलरली मंगा रहे हो भी योर होम फूड रीच इन फाइबर आर ऑलवेज बेटर. हाँ क्वेश्चन कम्स, वेदर सेफ टू टेक ए वेज डाइट और नॉन वेज डाइट, दैट चॉइस इज योर्स, दैट चॉइस इज योर्स. बट नाउ स्टडीज आर देयर, आई मीन नॉन वेज पर्सन आई एम टेलिंग ओपन मेनिंग, बट नाउ स्टडीज आर देयर दैट वेगन फूड्स, दैट इज द वेज फूड्स आर बेटर फॉर योर जीआई ट्रैक्ट एंड योर लाइफ. सो that you can. Now another cause, now they are saying, is the cholesterol content or fat content in your diet. If it is animal diet, animal fat or plant, your animal fat like your egg yolk etc., if taken in large amount, that may contribute towards the etiology of carcinoma colon. So animal, try to avoid animal fat, a fatty part of animal food like red meat. Red meat also contains a good amount of fat. So these are the points of this etiology. Etiology as regards why it is not common in the India or parts of Africa. It is not common in India or parts of Africa, but more common in USA and England. And you know, one interesting thing is that Africa, in Africa, the African population are not very vulnerable for carcinoma colon. But this African American, that is people of African origin, those who are established or they are staying in America for longer and they have opted for the American lifestyle, those people are more vulnerable than the people from America itself. Because their body, their genes have been adjusted differently, and now there is a change. So that is the about the food and others. Now question comes. That is one thing. What else? Why it is more common in the Western world? Because might have heard a condition called polyposis. Polyposis. That is colonic polyposis. That is more occurring of polyps in colon, and there are types, some type, multiple polyposis, colonic, this is non-cancerous and cancerous, like that. This polyposis, especially this adenomatous polyposis, contribute to a good amount of carcinoma, cause of carcinoma, and in that part. I told you in the beginning that the incidence in India is less. And what will be the incidence? Total incidence is about around 4. So 4.4 for male, 3.9 for female, like that. So roughly to remember, can remember 4. Around 4 in 1 lakh. 4 in 1 lakh. It is not a very great number considering what the incidence is there in the Western country. And next is that your what about the body weights? The body weight of the European or American people are more in comparison to Indians, both in for body weight and your body mass. That also contributes to the cause of carcinoma. Now, smoking, alcohol, these also add to the cause, to the risk. And it has been seen that most of the cases of cancers in the colon, most of the cases of cancer of the colon have been developed from the adenomatous polyp. Adenomatous polyp, about 2/3 of adenomatous polyp convert to malignancy. So whenever you find adenomatous polyp, one should be prepared. If it is not treated properly or not treated in time, then it may lead to your carcinoma of the colon. there occurs a change in the sequential genetic changes in the adenomatous polyp that is our mutation that causes the cells to convert to your malignancy. Now, it has been observed that in a case of patients with the adenomatous polyp studied, whatever the incidence today, suppose today 10 people, a person are having adenomatous polyp, after 5 years, in five years it changes about 2/3 of them, so about 6 to 7% of them will change to having malignancy. So whenever you see adenomatous polyp, this is the warning bell should ring. The more the size of the adenomatous polyp, the more chance, more possibility of converting into malignancy. So adenomatous polyp size more than 0.5 centimeter, that is 5 millimeter size, are there the every possibility that will be malignant in due course. Now, another cause they are attributing in right-sided colon particularly are the cases where cholecystectomy has been done. We know bile helps in digestion and absorption of the fat. So when we are removing the gallbladder, we are getting bile, no doubt, but concentrated bile what required we are not getting. So in some few cases, they have got the evidence that in long time of the cholecystectomy, there is possibility that there may be malignant changes. Now, there is a condition called HNPCC. HNPCC, that is hereditary non-polyposis colonic cancer. This is a hereditary condition. Polyposis is not there, but it is a hereditary condition where there is colonic carcinoma is there. This condition is otherwise known as Lynch syndrome, L-Y-N-C-H. Those who are syndrome master, you can remember Lynch syndrome, L-Y-N-C-H, Lynch syndrome. It is the most common of hereditary carcinoma of the colon, Lynch syndrome. And another condition is FAP, that is familial adenomatous polyp. This is adenomatous polyp stage, familial adenomatous polyp. This is not carcinoma. At present, that is benign, but some of them may convert into malignancy in due course. Now, most of the carcinoma of the large gut, that is the colon, arises in the left side. Actually, if you take together up to the rectum, there is colon and rectum. Many a times we deal as colorectal carcinoma. So total colorectal carcinoma, 2/3 are carcinoma are in the colon and 1/3 in rectum. Some books gives the incidence in between 35%, some gives up to 38%. So 35 to 38% will find in rectum. The rest, whatever 62 or 65%, they are in the colon. Out of these two, the left side colon are probably a little bit more. The third in occurrence, if you count it, the first in occurrence will be no doubt the rectum. The second will be the sigmoid colon, the descending colon and the sigmoid colon. That is second incidence. About more than 20% cases, more than 20% of the colorectal carcinoma occurs in that part, that is distal part of the colon. And about 12 to 13% occurs in the cecum. Rest jo raha hai aapas mein baant le, 2.5% kare baant lo, 2-3% baaki har jagah aaja, ascending colon, both flexors, transverse colon, descending colon, here 2-3, 4%, transverse colon is out because it longer part hai, 35.5%, baaki rest are almost 2-3, 4%. But main three important part, rectum 38%, sigmoid 22%, and your cecum 12%. That is the incidences, kahan hota hai. Now, what about the staging? Because cancer to cancer hai. But what about the staging? Staging kaise karte hain? There are two types of staging. One is ड्यूक स्टेजिंग, ड्यूक स्टेजिंग दी नेक्स्ट इज, आजकल जमाना ज्यादा चलता है TNN क्लासिफिकेशन। एक जमाना में ड्यूक क्लासिफिकेशन और ड्यूक स्टेजिंग वाज मोर फ्रीक्वेंटली यूज्ड, नाउ आल्सो इट इज बीइंग यूज्ड, बट इट इज वेरी सिंपल वन, थ्री स्टेज एंड TNM, TNNM, T फॉर ट्यूमर, N फॉर नोड, M फॉर मेटास्टेसिस। नाउ ड्यूक, ड्यूक इज ए बी सी, ए बी सी ये कितना डेप्थ तक हुआ है, कितना डेप्थ तक गया है, डेप्थ तक इन्वेड किया है कार्सिनोमा, कहां तक बना है उसी हिसाब से देख क्लासिफिकेशन मेड। T1 इज लिमिटेड ओनली टू द सब म्यूकोसा, मतलब म्यूकोस मेम्ब्रेन में है, सब म्यूकोसा तक गया है। इफ दैट ग्रोथ इज लिमिटेड टू द सब म्यूकोसा इन ड्यूक्स क्लासिफिकेशन दिस विल बी ए, ड्यूक्स ए। एंड व्हाट इज सॉरी अप टू मस्कुलरिस म्यूकोसा इफ इट इज देयर इट इज अप टू ड्यूक ए। व्हाट इज बी, व्हाट इज बी इज देयर देयर इज ब्रीच, ब्रीच इन द मस्कुलरिस प्रोक्रिया, ब्रीच हुआ है, दैट इज दैट पार्ट ऑलमोस्ट इंटेस्टाइनल वॉल तक चला गया है एंड लिम्फ नोड में भी इन्वॉल्व, दैट इज बी। देन सी आर व्हेन लिम्फ नोड इन्वॉल्वमेंट इज देयर पॉजिटिवली, इन्वॉल्व नहीं हुआ है लिम्फ नोड लेकिन वॉल ब्रीच किया है, मतलब नदी पार हो गया लेकिन बाढ़ नहीं आया है, बगल वाला गांव में डेंजर नहीं हुआ है। बी पहले क्या है, नदी का अंदर पानी है, ऊपर लेवल तक है, बाढ़ का जमाना चल रहा है अभी, ऊपर लेवल तक डेंजर लेवल तक बह रहा है। ए इनसाइड अप टू दी रोपिया। देन नेक्स्ट इज योर ब्रिज टिट, मतलब वॉल को ब्रिज किया है बट लिम्फ नोड को इन्वॉल्व नहीं किया है। देन सी इज वन लिम्फ नोड इन्वॉल्व इज दियर। ये ड्यूक साहब ने ए बी सी तीन बनाए थे, सब्सिक्वेंटली देखा गया कि डिस्टेंस मेटास्टेसिस भी हो रहा है, सो सम पीपल एडेड ए डी टू इट एंड डी स्टैंड्स फॉर मेटास्टेसिस और डिस्टेंस मेटास्टेसिस, डी स्टैंड्स फॉर डिस्टेंस मेटास्टेसिस। तो ए बी सी डी ड्यूक क्लासिफिकेशन एंड TNN विल बी टी, दैट इज फ्रॉम T0 T1 T2 T3 T4 लाइक दिस। सो व्हाट इज T0 क्या है, व्हेन यू आर अनएबल टू सी एनीथिंग, that is only in biopsy you have found it, T0. T1 is up to the submucosal level, T2 is gone up to the muscularis propria, T3 is gone up to the subserosa, but there is no break, subserous level to serous level to gaya, but there is no break, but T4 is when there is breaches the serous level, matlab pura wall cross ho gaya tumor ka, that is T4. Now N0 is no nodal metastasis or no node lymph node is involved. N1 is 1-3 नंबर सब नोड्स, एक साइड में जहां हुआ है उसका 1-3 नंबर, 3 नंबर तक नोड, 1-2-3 नंबर भी अगर हुआ है तो उसको अपन 2 में रखेंगे, एंड नाउ सॉरी N1 में रखेंगे, एंड N2 विल बी मोर देन 4, मोर देन 4 नोड्स इन बल, एंड ऑफ कोर्स M में M0 इज नो मेटास्टेसिस एंड M1 इज मेटास्टेसिस इज देयर। सो दैट इज द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द ग्रुप। नाउ कमिंग टू द टॉपिक दैट हैज बीन गिवन टू अस, दैट इज द clinical feature, that is the important part as per today's topic, though everything is important as per today's topic, clinical feature. I told you clinical feature are limitedly, mainly the main part is limited to 3, but now see, let us see how we can enumerate all this. Now there may be symptoms or there may not be symptoms, initially there may be symptoms or for long period there may not be symptoms, and at times what happens, only the features of metastasis are there and no clinical symptoms are noted for quite long period. So patient may remain, in other words, patient may remain asymptomatic for quite a long period. Now, this is a disease of the older generation, you can call it. This is more common, though it is found in people with 30-40 years also, it is found. It is more common up to the age of 50 years. More common after the age of 50 years. Rather, in Western country where the livelihood is up to 7th, 8th, 9th decade, it is more common in the 7th and 8th decade. Disease of the 8th decade, they are calling it. Disease of the 8th decade, because 70 to 80 is the most vulnerable period having carcinoma of the colon. So, that is the age incidence. Initially, we have discussed about the incidences in Western world and Indian world. Now, the age incidence more in the older age group and slightly higher incidence in male in comparison to female. Now there may be a family history in the family of the disease. Same family may previous history, some persons having a carcinoma of the colon may be there. And when that occurs, family history in close relatives, that is first degree relatives having carcinoma colon below the age of 45, below the age of 45 is otherwise called a colorectal cancer familial syndrome. Colorectal cancer familial syndrome when it occurs in below 45 years of age and must be in the first degree relative. First degree relative means son, daughter, father, mother, sister. This is the first degree relative. Now, somehow the lesions in the plexus, that is the hepatic flexors and splenic flexors, that may not be noticed for quite a longer period. Somehow those remains symptom-free for quite a long period. And this clinical feature may vary according to the site of the site and type, both site and type of the lesion. Clinical features jo hai disease ka vary kar sakta hai according to site and type of the lesion. Now clinical features are generally of three. Ek obstructive features hoga. Now that is the large intestine obstruction hoga. The obstructive feature. The second bleeding hoga. Maybe malignancy bleeding hoga. And third, complications of bleeding, you can say there will be anemia. Present patient may case anemia, that is due to disease bhi hai, wo nahi mila, but present may present anemia. Leaving aside anemia, you can say mainly that it will be either obstructive features or bleeding. Now question comes, if the obstructive feature, what sort of? Kya sort of obstruction hoga, kyun hoga? Because number one, the type of growth. Jo growth hua hai, kis type ka hua hai? Number one is annular. Annular. Annular means anybody jiska shaadi hua hai ya engagement hua hai. A ring pehnte ho, ring pehna jata hai. What is shape of the ring? Ring se pehnte.
Annular.
Charo taraf se hoga. Lekin jyada chauda nahi hoga. सर्कुलर नॉट सर्कुलर इट इज सर्कुलर नो डाउट बट विथ सम रेज पार्ट भी रहेगा ना ओनली सर्कुलर होने से नहीं होगा रेज भी होगा लेकिन दैट विड्थ ज्यादा नहीं है उसका रिंग छल्ला छल्ला टाइप का चारों तरफ छल्ला टाइप का ग्रोथ होगा तो पहले रिंग टाइप का होगा या फिर कैसा हो क्या हो सकता है नेक्स्ट ग्रोथ कैसा हो सकता है इट विल बी लाइक ए ट्यूब पहले रिंग अंगूठा या अंगूठी पहनने वाला अंगूठी और सेकंड इज ट्यूब लाइक ए ट्यूब लंबा होकर रहेगा दैट ग्रोथ विल बी लंगर मोर देन 2 सेंटीमीटर 3 सेंटीमीटर 4 सेंटीमीटर बट इट विल बी ऑल अराउंड चारों तरफ होगा ग्रोथ एंड लंबा एरिया होगा दो हो गया तीन नंबर क्या होगा एक अल्सरेटेड पार्ट होगा मिट्टी से पहले तो हिड बांध बना दिए हैं उसके बाद क्या हुआ चौड़ा हिड या मेड़ बन गया चौड़ा उसके बाद क्या हुआ दो फौड़ा फावड़ा से दो चार चोट लगा लो मार दो तो गड्ढा बन गया एक गड्ढा वाला अल्सर पहले रिंग वाला हुआ फिर ट्यूब वाला हुआ फिर क्या हुआ एक गड्ढा वाला दैट इज अल्सरेटेड लीजन देयर विल बी सम अल्सर एंड द नेक्स्ट वन इज ए गोभी पत्ता को कैसे फूल गोभी कॉलीफ्लावर लाइक लीजन और एक्सप्लोरेटिव लीजन कॉलीफ्लावर लाइक लीजन ग्रोथ हो जाए आउट ग्रोथ होगा सो देयर फोर टाइप ऑफ ग्रोथ है दिस ग्रोथ तो इसमें क्या होगा सबसे सबसे पहले क्या होगा ज्यादा ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन किसमें होगा जिसमें चारों तरफ से हो रहा है आइदर एनुलर और ट्यूबुलर इस ग्रोथ में क्या होगा जरूर भी ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन इज बट दिस ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन इनिशियली दैट में प्रेजेंट एज ए स्लो बिकट इज स्लोली स्लोली एंड इफ इज द राइट साइड व्हाट इज हैपन लिक्विड स्टूल लेस पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन लेफ्ट साइड फॉर्म स्टूल इफ ग्रोथ इज देयर मोर पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन सो ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव फीचर विल बी more prominent when it is there in the left side. Correct? So what obstructive feature will there and what happened? You understand it, what I am telling? What will happen? There will be constipation. Initially, there will be constipation. Constipation hote hote kya hoga? Liquid stool jam jayega, right side mein hoga, kuch to absorb ho jayega pani. Uske baad jab zyada ho jayega, kya hoga? पूरा प्रोसेस डायरिया आपका निकल जाएगा. सो देयर इज अल्टरेशन इन बाउल हैबिट, अल्टरेशन इन बाउल हैबिट, कॉन्स्टिपेशन फॉलोड बाय डायरिया. पेशेंट आके कंप्लेन करेगा, साहब बार बार मुझे ऐसा होता है, पहले दो चार दिन तो लिटरेट नहीं होता है, पांच सात दिन नहीं हो पाता लिटरेट, लेकिन जब जाता है बहुत फर्क जाता है. दैट इज अल्टरेशन ऑफ बाउल हैबिट. मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट सिम्टम्स इफ सच इज देयर, आपको सोचना ट्रेन में मस्ट एक्सरसाइज द पॉसिबिलिटी कॉज ऑफ लार्ज बाउल ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन इज देयर एंड मोस्ट लाइकली मे बी मैलिग्नेंसी, वेरी प्रोस्पेक्टिव फीचर. नाउ इफ दैट इज ऑन द राइट साइड होगा तो लिक्विड स्टूल less chance, left side more chance. Then what happens? Acute obstruction and chronic obstruction. Constipation will strike gradually, gradually there will be chronic obstruction. Patient will not come. But at times what happens? Suppose in the left side or sigmoid colon or at the turning or at the curvature, the growth is there or growth is there. And in the growth itself may cause an acute obstruction or desiccated feces. Feces kya kar rahe? Body kya kar rahe hai? Large intestine? Pani to sook rahe ho. सॉलिड को छोड़ दे रहा है, छोड़ते छोड़ते वो सूख जाएगा, बॉल बन जाएगा, नॉन आई थिकोलिट्स, थिकोलिट विल फॉर्म, ड्राई फिसेस हो जाएगा, दैट मे इटसेल्फ कॉज ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन, द ग्रोथ इटसेल्फ मे कॉज ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन, एंड दोज ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन मे बी एक्यूट फीचर, एक्यूट इंटेस्टिनल ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन ऑफ योर कम टू द इमरजेंसी. सो इन अदर वर्ड्स इट इज एन इमरजेंसी प्रोसीजर, इमरजेंसी एडमिशन, एंड माइंड इट, इमरजेंसी लार्ज बाउल ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन carries a poor prognosis, carries a poor prognosis, more risky, more possible that in Western country like UK, about 20% cases of large bile obstruction are due to malignant cause. Not in India, it is a little lesser in India, no doubt. We have some other causes like bulbulus, some other causes like band, like that, some tuberculosis can also cause large bile obstruction. So like that in our country, but there in the Western country, it is more common. So that is about the large bile obstruction, large bile obstruction due to colonic cancer. Next, what will there? Bleeding. Where from bleeding will come? Because the growth is there, there will be exfoliation of the mucosa. So bleeding will be there. Now bleeding can be, that was the obstruction. Now bleeding. Bleeding can be of three types. One, it can be in microscopic level. That is, when you do a blood test, stool test. Ab kya stool test karte ho blood ke liye? Occult blood test. When you do a occult blood test, it comes positive. Positive for blood. That is, this hemoferritin molecules are there in the stool. कैसे क्या चेंज होता है, क्या ग्रुप का होता है, आप लोग देख लेना उसको. मेनली दी हीमोफेरिटिन पार्ट दैट इज द कलर, दैट कलर चेंज. सो दैट इज इन माइक्रोस्कोपिक लेवल. देन नेक्स्ट ए लिटिल आंख में दिख रहा है, स्टूल के साथ आ रहा है, तुमको दिख रहा है. इसमें क्या है, आपको ब्लड नहीं दिख रहा है, आइदर ब्लैक थोड़ा बहुत ब्लैक दिख सकता है और कुछ नहीं दिख रहा है आपको. व्हेन यू आर एग्जामिनिंग द स्टूल यू आर नोइंग दैट सम पार्ट ऑफ ब्लडिंग इज देयर. Next third is profuse bleeding. So three level of bleeding. There are four level of obstruction. Here it is three types of bleeding. One is microscopic, known by this occult blood test. Second is little bit of bleeding. Then third is profuse bleeding, emergency admission, profuse bleeding. So that is the type of bleeding. So obstruction and bleeding, those are important. So क्या होगा obstruction होने से, क्या होगा intestinal obstruction, other features होगा, bloating होगा, distension abdomen होगा, constipation होगा, obstipation होगा, all these things will come. Altered bowel habit होगा, it's there. Now, just I forgot that I told you there is a profuse bleeding. That frank or profuse bleeding has a term called hematochagia. Frank bleeding जब होता है, we call it hematochagia. In the frank stool in the blood, most stool in the blood. Now ब्लीडिंग होगा तो पेशेंट एनिमिक होगा, वीक होगा, फैटिग होगा, वट एवर आप जो जोड़ सकते हैं उसमें जोड़ो उसको. देन थर्ड इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, वन इंपॉर्टेंट इज योर ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव फीचर, सेकेंड इंपॉर्टेंट इज ब्लीडिंग, थर्ड इज पाल्पेबल लम्प. ये कार्सिनोमा होता है तो लम्प फॉर्मेशन होता है, लम्प फॉर्मेशन में जान लीजिए. बोथ द कार्सिनोमा इटसेल्फ and mangivellum or carcinoma along with the stored stool. That will give you the lung. And in the stored stool, how can you tell? When you examine, clinical examination, when you go to the ward, I don't know whether you have seen or not. If you press it, you'll be able to press. You'll be able to press that mass. Finger लगाओगे तो dipping जैसे क्या होता है? आटा का लेहिम जैसे अंगली घुस दबाने से घुस जाता है. That will feel like that. That your finger is going. After some time, yes, filled up. That indicates that probably there is dry, semi-dry stool is there. So that is the lump abdomen. Lump can be कहाँ होगा lump? कहीं भी हो सकता है. कहीं भी मतलब large intestine जहाँ भी है, colon जहाँ पर है. Starting from cecum to the sigmoid colon, जहाँ भी है उस जगह में वो lump होगा. So lump is a feature. जहाँ lump होगा, तो now differential कैसे करोगे? Differential कैसे करोगे? Differential diagnosis में lump जहाँ है वहीं का हम लोग करना. Right iliac fossa है, तो right iliac fossa में और क्या-क्या lump हो सकता है? With this clinical features को तुम उसको rule out करना. अगर से राइट इलियक फोसा में नहीं होगा, राइट हाइपोकॉन्ड्रियम में हुआ, तो उसमें जो कॉजेस है गैप लॉन्ग इन द राइट इलियक, उसको रूल आउट करोगे एक एक करके पूरा. यू कैन एक्सेप्टिंग द प्रोबेबिलिटी अम्बेलिकल रीजन दिस कवर्स ऑल द रेस्ट एट रीजंस, बाकी आठ जगह. तो दैट्स क्लिनिकल अबाउट द क्लिनिकल साइट. क्लिनिकल एग्जामिनेशन दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट, और इन योर क्लिनिकल एग्जामिनेशन आल्सो दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट, बिकॉज ये गॉट carcinoma, large gut carcinoma can be there in almost anywhere except in rarely umbilicus. I don't say it is umbilicus nahi hoga. Umbilicus mein kaise hoga? Can anybody think? Can a coronic carcinoma be there in the umbilicus, umbilical region, present in the umbilical region? Can anybody think? When it is in the growth is there in the transverse colon, because of the weight it hangs down. Niche aa jayega. So in that case you will find it in the अमेरिका रीजन आल्सो, बट दैट इज नॉट वेरी कॉमन. सो टोटल बाकी रेस्ट पोर्शन इट कैन बी देयर एनीवेयर. सो दैट इज द लॉन्ग फॉर्मेशन इज देयर. नाउ देयर विल बी अनएक्सप्लेन वेट लॉस. कोई कारण तुमको नहीं मिल रहा है, बट देयर मस्ट बी सम रीजन. और वेट लॉस हो रहा है तो किसमें होता है? आइदर ट्यूबरकुलोसिस में होता है, मैलिग्नेंसी में होता है, और देयर आर सम रेयर कंडीशंस. तो in India the tuberculosis is easier. Anybody in any city can diagnose tuberculosis mostly agar thoda sa clinical experience hai to. But what about in England? TB is not common in western country. TB is not common, so they have to differentiate. And one of the common reason is the unexplained weight loss is the carcinoma of the colon. Carcinoma colon kyun? Why not in the small intestine? Because I told you in the beginning, because of the diameter, bigger diameter than the small intestine, presentation that will take longer time for obstructive feature to develop. So you can find the features of unexplained weight loss, unexplained weight loss. And then what investigations you are going to do? Lab, routine lab investigations you will do. What about karte ho hemoglobin se leke jo routine karte ho, plus one is this. One important is carcinomembranic antigen, CEA. CEA is now it is being done, and if the CEA is more, that will indicate that possibility malignancy is there. And what else? Other kya other investigation kya karoge baki? It will be one is lab, then the other is your imaging. What imaging? Plain X-ray may not show you anything. So what we do, we can take a double contrast X-ray. Double contrast, matlab you give two contrast. And what are those two contrast? One contrast barium you give. So you give a barium enema X-ray or barium mill X-ray with and you push little bit air inside. So that gives a contrast, air and this contrast, and any filling defect you can note it well. So that is about the double contrast X-ray of the large intestine. Now, that is X-ray, because though it is non-invasive, it expose you to radiation. Now, less radiation procedures, less radiation are there, and that is your ultrasonography and CT scan. Ultrasonography gets you size along the region of the lung. Whereas CT will determine exactly what is the size and what is the site and what is the present obstruction, obstructive feature is there, whether it is absolutely, absolutely obstructing or some still some ways are left behind. So that is about the CT scan. Now comes one important thing is that colonoscopy. And what is colonoscopy? You pass a flexible fiber optic scope. Those who have not seen a colonoscope, when the corona period is over and you come to measure OT, and even fortunately my OT day, then you ask me, I will show you a colonoscope. I may not be able to show you their procedure because procedure is not done regularly here in our institute. But I can show you, you can see the upper NGI endoscope. I can show you both upper GI endoscopy in OPD procedure. We are doing it almost regularly, but not now in corona period. So many of you might have seen also. But this is the here you need a lower GI one colonoscope. So colonoscope will give you two things. One, it can give you the diagnosis that in obstruction is there or not. Number two, if any growth is there, you can take a biopsy. But mind you, this is a invasive procedure, and because this is invasive procedure, you have to prepare the patient. बायल प्रिपरेशन दिया सो नाउ आज का अभी जैसे हम लोग पढ़ाई कर रहे हैं ना वर्चुअल दुनिया में वर्चुअल पढ़ाई कर रहे हैं ऐसे वर्चुअल एंडोस्कोपी कर सकते हो तुम कैसे करोगे वर्चुअल एंडोस्कोपी वर्चुअल कोलोनोस्कोपी कैसे करोगे अपन तो मशीन सामने बैठे कर रहे हैं वहां वर्चुअल कैसे करते हैं दैट इज इट इज सॉर्ट ऑफ सीटी तो सीटी करते हो सीटी स्कैन को सीटी कोलोनोस्कोपी सीटी का टाइम क्या है थैंक यू तो इट इज सीटी कोलोनोस्कोपी नॉन इनवेसिव प्रोसीजर द सीटी फाइंडिंग व्हाट एवर देयर देयर इज रिकंस्ट्रक्टेड दैट इज नंबर फर्स्ट इट इज नॉन इनवेसिव प्रोसीजर कहीं कहीं एक शॉर्ट नोट आ सकता है यो को वर्चुअल कोलोनोस्कोपी के जमाना वर्चुअल का है तो वर्चुअल रिलेटेड तुम लोग तैयार रहना वर्चुअल कोलोनोस्कोपी इट इज ए सीटी कोलोनोस्कोपी नॉन इनवेसिव प्रोसीजर दिस यूजेस एक्सरे एंड द इमेजिंग and 2D and 3D, 2D and 3D images of the entire colon are taken by your CT and those displays in a monitor. And there they are reconstructed. A 3D images are reconstructed. So you can see the edges and you can see the lumen of the large gut. In that, you can see the lumen and almost like an endoscopy can go. And you can see whole of that, you can study whole of that. So now this is a recent development. Virtual endoscopy or virtual colonoscopy. Advantage is that it is non-invasive procedure. Disadvantage is that if you want to take a biopsy, you cannot take. If you want to take a biopsy to confirm the diagnosis, then you have to go for a colonoscopy. Correct? Now, ये तो तुमने endoscopy कर लिया, ये कर लिया, diagnosis कर लिया, and this virtual ये मत सोचो क्या फोटो है जो कम दिखेगा इवन अप टू ए साइज ऑफ 5 टू 6 मिलीमीटर साइज 5 टू 6 मिलीमीटर साइज का पॉलीप अगर होगा फिर भी इसमें दिख जाएगा वर्चुअल में सो नाउ क्या करना चाहिए उसमें क्या करना चाहिए इस टाइप का अगर केस हुआ तो क्या करोगे रेडियोलॉजी कर लिया कोलोनोस्कोपी कर लिया नाउ टू थिंग्स वन इज प्रिवेंशन Or before prevention, early diagnosis rather. Prevention तो अपन नहीं बोल सकते because आप अमेरिका को जाके बोलो चाहे इंडियन खाना खाओ तो उन लोग तैयार नहीं होंगे. So early diagnosis. For early diagnosis, what do you do? They have made a protocol. In USA, anybody above 50 years, that is in 50 to 75 years, yearly they are asking for a two-level blood test, screening test. Screening test tool for occult blood. If it is positive, then they are asking for colonoscopy. In England, they are taking 60 to 69. 70 का दशक जिसको बोलते हैं हम लोग हिंदी में 70 का दशक 60 और 61 to 69 ये जो पीरियड है everybody are subjected to your occult blood test. If occult blood test is positive, then ask for colonoscopy. In colonoscopy, if any growth Then take biopsy. If some polyp you are seeing, you can directly remove that polyp, a single polyp. If it is polyposis, then the treatment will differ. So early diagnosis, even in polyposis, it gives a proportionately better result, better prognosis. So that is regarding the early diagnosis. Now treatment. What treatment you can do? Main treatment depend at what stage you have diagnosed it. Suppose there is metastasis, there is no, and if there is metastasis, where it is metastasis, it can metastasize to the wall adjacent. It can metastasize to adjacent organ. It can metastasize because large gut, especially in cecum and in sigmoid, rectum, it is in contact with the retroperitoneum. So even a retroperitoneal growth may be there. So it may grow to retroperitoneum, flexor, splenic flexor in contact with pancreas. pancreatic part may be involved. Right side hepatic flexor or duodenum may be involved. So these you must see and you must be careful while planning for surgery which structure might have been involved, like this ureter on the right side or both the sides the ureter may be involved. So you must be careful while planning. So planning number one is that if you can able to remove that growth without metastasis, then it is giving the better prognosis. I know patients, though you are live for last 10, 15 years. And I know, I have heard my professor saying that patients are living for 15, 20 years. At that time, when the prognosis were not very good, but with better hand, they have a good prognosis. So what do you do? If the growth is, it will depend where is the growth. Suppose the growth is in the right side, either the cecum up to the, say, hepatic flexor. What do you do? You do a right hemicolectomy. Right hemicolectomy, that means all that part is removed over either. And now here another question comes, surgery, which surgery you are planning? Whether it is laparoscopic surgery or it is a open surgery. Mostly in India, open surgery are done, but now in many places, they have started doing laparoscopic surgery. They have started doing good laparoscopic surgery, they are doing also with laparoscopy. But open surgery, that was considered open surgery. Right side, right hemicolectomy, what you do? You remove that portion of the cecum up to the flexor, hepatic flexor. That part is removed by cauterization, first cauterize. Then remove that after tying the arteries and veins. And you can go for an end-to-end anastomosis or end-to-end anastomosis. That is if it is in the right side. If it is in the left side, suppose in the transverse column, then you may have to go for a extended hemicolectomy. Extended hemicolectomy, that means up to the splenic flexor, from the distal ileum to the hepatic flexor, splenic flexor. So you have removed the whole part. So what part is there? The descending column part is there. And, this is, and now this part of the ileum, you are anastomosing to the ileum, or that is main, or when the left side growth is there, then the whole of the left side, the left hemicolectomy is there, and yeah, either you do an anastomosis if possible, and if the anastomosis is not possible, you ask for a permanent functional colostomy, if you are not able to, that is, if the anal part is also involved, or there is very less, more than 5 cm, if your end of the GIT, that is the NSM rectum is there, then you can go for a anastomosis, or else you can go for. So now that is standard open, but with the advent of use of this stapler, circular stapler, now people with 3 cm length of anal canal, they are doing the anastomosis, long anastomosis possible. So that is what now people are doing. But anyway, for standard, you remember, right hemicolectomy, extended right hemicolectomy, left hemicolectomy. Major surgery. So that is the surgical part. You know, in case when there is metastasis is there, or if recurrence is there, you can go for chemotherapy agent. So that is in gist. And world is changing, the methods are changing, there is improvement. What people want, people say that cancer ho gaya to mar gaya, it is not like that. Something is good that if diagnosed properly, in time rather, if diagnosed in time and procedure is done, then prognosis is not that very bad, not that very bad, but malignancy is malignancy. So, see that it should not occur. And नहीं करने के लिए क्या अपने इंडियन सिचुएशन में कुछ तो गॉड का गिवन सिचुएशन ऐसा है कि अपन फाइबर एवरेज डाइट ज्यादा खाते हैं, कुछ मसालेदार चीज खाते हैं, दारू और कम पीते हैं. आई डोंट नो व्हाट यू आर पीपल आर डूइंग. सो दारू और कम पीते हैं, तीन फूड कम खाते थे. आजकल जो लोग जा रहे हैं, कोई बैंगलोर में पुणे में है, लोग क्या है दिन भर काम कर रहे हैं और रात को जो है खाना लेके आ रहे हैं, मियाँ बीवी दोनों कमा के ला रहे हैं और ला के आके सब जहर खा रहे हैं. So what will happen? Later on, हम लोग we are coping, not coping, we are aping, बंदरिंग. एक बंदर को बंदर जैसे कुछ देख के करता है, जो देख के करता है, हम लोग फॉरेन सिविलाइजेशन को ऐप करेंगे तो यही मिलेगा हमको साथ में. एक के साथ एक फ्री, उनका सिविलाइजेशन के साथ बीमारी भी फ्री मिलेगा. So let us expect that we are not following them and let us hope that this disease is not become rampant in India. Thank you. आप कुछ पूछना चाहते हो तो इसके बारे में आप पूछ सकते हो. I'm having another question. I think 12th we are having some demonstration class. ये virtual में demonstration will be a difficult thing, but मैं चाहता हूँ that period is 3 to 4. तुम लोग देख लो, आपस में बात कर लो. अगर 3 to 4 जगह में 12 से 1 हो या 11 से 12 हो या 10 से 11 भी हो,
12
से एक दे सकते हो तो आधा घंटा अपन डेमो ले सकते
हैं. 12 से
9 से 12 जब बोलेगे ठीक है मेरे लिए. मैं कल तो मैं ड्यूटी में रहूंगा तो परसों में तो 9 बजे आ जाऊंगा हॉस्पिटल में. मुझे जब बोलोगे आपस में बात करें मुझे बता देना.
9 से
12
के बीच में
बता दो अपन, क्योंकि डेमो सामने दिखाना चाहिए. मैं सोचता हूँ आज कैसे क्या क्या शो कर सकता हूँ. हाँ नहीं, मैं इसमें इसलिए प्रोजेक्टर में लेके उसको कुछ करने के लिए कोशिश करेंगे. ऐसा करके दिखाने से ज्यादा ये नहीं होगा. सो पहले दिन लेट अस स्टार्ट. मैं कोशिश कर रहा हूँ आइदर इंस्ट्रूमेंट हो या एक्सरे हो, मिसल डेमो में रख लेंगे उसको जो हो पाएगा. सो थैंक यू ऑल. ज्यादा कम ही जाएंगे.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.